I'm Nancy Siegel, Associate Professor of Art History at Towson University, and the focus of my research is the art and culinary history of the early American Republic. And my interest in this topic began when I was completing a research project that dealt with imported ceramics from the 1830s. This occurred at the same time in 2003 when the French government decided to oppose American military action in Iraq, prompting a member of Congress to suggest that French fries could no longer be called French fries in federal cafeterias. Rather, they must be called freedom fries. Still looking at the bottom of the soup plate, I wondered, was there a connection between art, politics, and culinary history? A culinary vocabulary developed rapidly in the early Republic. The colonies were often referred to as a kettle of fish or a crumbling cake. Taxes on tea were a major issue for the colonists, and in fact, potters responded by literally placing objects of protest in the colonists' hands, such as this teapot, protesting the Stamp Act of 1765, and likewise their aversions in 1766, celebrating its repeal. Just after the Revolution, Amelia Simmons is credited with developing the first American cookbook, American Cookery. In addition to recipes for Independence cake, there are cakes in praise of presidents and political figures. Another culinary example is the mammoth cheese, a 1,235-pound cheddar cheese made by the farmers of Cheshire, Massachusetts in 1801 to praise the presidency of Thomas Jefferson. By studying early American foodways and material culture, my research focuses on how and why a culinary vocabulary developed in the years surrounding the American Revolution, a topic that still resonates today. Freedom fries or a slice of Obama cake, anyone?